Hi everyone, and welcome to Dynamics 365 Bytes. My name is Teodora Ivanova, and today I am going to talk about what is managed environments for Power Platform. According to Gartner, 70% of the applications in the enterprise organizations will be created using local by 2025. But the proof of our progress and the momentum comes from our customers. Companies are choosing Microsoft Business applications, and today we have 500,000 organizations each month using Dynamics 365 and Power Platform, and 97% of them are Fortune 500 companies. And from zero users and zero developers on the Power Platform, we now have over 7.4 million creators on the Power Platform every single month. That is incredible, and it will continue to grow. And while we do have a viral adoption of the platform today, there are challenges to be solved. Managed environments for Power Platform is one aspect of the premium features available for organizations when using Microsoft Power Platform. And executives agree that the impact of the IT governance and the visibility of data and connectors is greatly improved with these features. And Microsoft Power Platform plays a key role in the broader Microsoft Cloud architecture. Power Platform runs on top of Azure, and hence the platform benefits from the strengths of Azure security, advanced management capabilities, and the rich set of industry-specific certifications for banks, pharmas, and government organizations. Scenarios in SharePoint, Teams, and Dynamics 365 products rely on the Power Platform as a service for automation and app customization. If you're already using SharePoint or Teams, you're most likely already using the Power Platform. While low-code solutions improve agility and cost savings among their many benefits, they aren't the silver lining to all of an organization's problems. Not all low-code platforms are the same, and security controls vary between platforms. As such, security and compliance are seen as areas that need further attention. Although low-code mitigates some security risks, citizen developers bring new challenges. The low-code movement can turn anyone into a developer, but it can't turn anyone into a security-aware developer. Citizen developers aren't likely to be trained in an application security, and secure dev product and processes don't take citizen developers into account. Some specific security concerns include IT resource limitations to manage a growing number of low-code assets and inability to scale to meet business demands. A lack of visibility and application inventory, application lifecycle management, suboptimal levels of data oversight and control over those assets to bring clarity to the chaos, and unwitting development of shadow IT projects, including trial purchases and storage of data in non-IT approved software or cloud service. While organizations may use multiple low-code providers to build solutions, IT will be required to learn how to build and enforce governance strategy on each of those tools. Microsoft Power Platform provides powerful governance tooling for IT administrators to manage their low-code assets with one central location, the Power Platform Admin Center. While the Power Platform Admin Center and the Center of Excellence Starter Kit are extremely powerful and packed with features and allow IT administrators to enforce solid governance strategy, there must be an easier way to govern and scale and meet the demands of business without stretching IT team. Managed environments for Power Platform adds to the powerful governance features IT administrators have come to expect and now allows for a streamlined approach to low-code asset governance at scale. Managed environments for Power Platform is built on three core pillars: more visibility, more control, and less effort. With more visibility, organizations can gain valuable insights into how solutions are being built, what data is accessible to those solutions, and who is using those solutions. Usage information can be sent proactively to your inbox weekly, so you no longer need to log into the admin center. Time to solution with Microsoft Power Platform is incredibly fast, but ensuring those solutions adhere to your governance policies is crucial. With managed environments for Power Platform, IT has more control to train the sharing of applications, ensure solutions meet reliability and security rules, and provide makers a custom onboarding experience to build solutions with guidance. All of those features are activated and managed through the Power Platform Admin Center. With a click of a button, IT administrators can easily enable and configure managed environments for proactive guidance of their low-code assets. And managed environments is a key part of the Power Platform family. In the same way that AI Builder infuses intelligence into our products and Dataverse provides the data backbone, managed environments streamlines governance of the platform. Power Platform offers several options for organizations to implement governance and security of their low-code assets, including the Power Platform Admin Center, a single place where administrators can go build and enforce their governance policies. Then we have also the Center of Excellence Starter Kit, that is a collection of components built using the Power Platform and allows organizations to get started developing a strategy for growth, adoption, and supporting Microsoft Power Platform. Managed Environments allows organizations to streamline their governance at scale with features that provide more visibility, more control, and all of that with less effort. And stay tuned. The next episode, I will be looking into every one of the features that Managed Environments has today, how to set it up, and how to use it. Managed Environment features can be enabled per environment, so you can experiment and test with it without affecting all environments in the tenant. To enable managed environments, you need to be a global administrator, Power Platform Service Administrator, or Dynamics 365 Administrator. There are two ways to enable it. You can go to the Power Platform Admin Center, select an environment, and click on Enable Managed Environments on the top. That way, you can also specify the settings for the environment, such as shown on the screenshot. The other way, to specifically useful if you want to enable managed environments at scale, is to use the PowerShell command available. And when we talk about managed environments, it is good to mention the licensing. Managed environments are already included with your Dynamics 365 Enterprise licenses, so we can encourage you to try it out today. For Power Platform environments, which are using the E3 E5 licensing, a Power Apps Premium license is needed for every user running an app in the environment, and Power Automate Premium license is needed for every user running a standalone flow in such an environment. Thank you very much for listening today, and stay tuned for the next episodes of the Managed Environments.